Smart home technology is pretty exciting. I've been putting smart home stuff in my house for the past several years, and it is all kinds of awesome and fun. It just makes everything so much easier. But there's a few basics that we need to understand. First of all, there's the actual network protocols. I know that sounds complicated, but I'll hopefully simplify it. And then we have the digital voice assistant ecosystem as well, which we'll get into. All these smart home devices have to be able to talk with some central hub so that everything knows how to operate. So there are a few different networking protocol standards out there. The main ones would be Wi-Fi, which you're probably familiar with. There's also a couple ones called Zigbee and Z-Wave. And finally, Apple's got their own called Apple HomeKit. So let's start with Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi works on kind of a star configuration. You've got the one main router, your Wi-Fi router. I think we're probably familiar with that. Everyone's got one in their home now. Gives you internet to all your devices. But it also acts as a kind of hub for smart home devices that use that particular standard. So when you're going into the store or looking online, just make sure if that's the network that you want to go with, that it has that that Wi-Fi symbol on there. So essentially, every device that you hook up, whether that's a smart switch or a smart light, will basically communicate with your router. They all typically work with their own apps. There's also other apps, home networking apps, that'll allow you to kind of congregate them all together. But the nice thing about Wi-Fi, it's pretty simple. You don't have to buy any other hubs or bridges to make that all work. So the next ones I mentioned would be Zigbee and Z-Wave. So these are low power mesh type home networking standards. And again, they've got their own symbol, so you'd want to look for that on the box when you're looking for your smart home products. And so what a mesh network does is that it actually uses all the devices to create the network. You are going to have some type of hub or bridge. This is like a little device that you would plug into your router that allows you to communicate with all these devices. But the advantage to the mesh network is that all these devices, whether that's like a smart switch, smart vacuum, smart light bulb, they all act as potential repeaters as well. So they can actually help extend your network out further in your home with all the different devices kind of connecting to each other. It's almost kind of like a self-healing network as well. Another advantage with Zigbee and Z-Wave is that they're low power compared to Wi-Fi home automated stuff. So that might be appealing for some people. Finally, there's Apple HomeKit. Of course, Apple loves their own ecosystem. The nice thing about the Apple stuff is that if you are in the Apple world, it's super simple to actually connect all those things together. And it actually will work with a combination of different ways. Some Apple HomeKit devices can just kind of work with themselves. Some might need an Apple HomeKit bridge or hub to make it work with your network. But they'll typically tell you that on the box or in the instructions. And so with the Apple world, the nice thing is just that they're super secure and super simple to set up. In many cases, all you have to do is scan the HomeKit barcode that comes included inside the box, and it just makes it really simple to get up and going on your network. But again, it's its own ecosystem. Of course, it'll work with all the Apple devices in your world, and will also work with the Siri voice assistant. Okay, let's go up another level and talk about the ecosystem of digital assistants. These things are super popular, and I think a lot of people already have some type of device in their home. And again, there's three main voice assistants. There's Google, there's Apple with Siri, that works with their HomeKit, and there's also Amazon. They've got their Echo line of speakers, and they use the Amazon Alexa voice assistant. So starting with Google, they were the first ones that actually came into Canada. They've got a whole bunch of different types of smart speaker devices. This one is probably familiar to a lot of folks. This was one of the first ones that they had out. But they've been evolving that. This is the latest Google Nest Audio. Looks really nice, fits really well in any type of home decor, the Google Mini. And they've also got the Google Nest Hub series as well. They've got the screens on them, which make it nice for watching videos and looking up recipes and what have you. And so typically to hook up your smart home stuff with this, you'd use the Google Home app on either your smartphone or your tablet, and it goes and finds all the smart home devices in your house and kind of congregates them all into that app. So it makes it easy to see them all and also to be able to use your voice. And that's super cool. I can basically get Google to tell my robot vacuum, my Roomba, to start vacuuming. Siri is another voice assistant, but that will typically only work with the HomeKit devices that are in your network. So if you've gone down that HomeKit route, the Apple HomeKit route, then you would be using Siri. And so Siri's built into iPhones, iPads, MacBooks, Apple TVs, and also their HomePod digital assistant speaker as well. The last one here would be Amazon. And they have their Echo line of digital assistants. They've got the small ones. They've got all sorts of different shapes and sizes. Of course, they've got the ones with the screen called their Amazon Echo Show series. Kind of work really similar to the other ones. They have an Amazon Alexa app. And what they have is something called Skills. And this is kind of nice. It actually makes it easy to hook up those smart home devices to it. If you had a Roomba robotic vacuum, for example, you would basically go into the Amazon Alexa app, type in Roomba, and you would download the skill for that. And from that point forward, all your Amazon devices would recognize your voice commands to get that basically going. You'll also start finding that whether it's Amazon or Google, that other devices are having those voice assistants built into it. So for example, I have an Ecobee smart thermostat. It actually has Amazon Alexa built into it. So there's all sorts of those types of things being integrated as well. Most of these devices out on the marketplace actually will let you use a combination of these voice assistants, especially when it comes to the Alexa and the Google assistants. So make sure that you look for the little symbols on the device that you're purchasing, just to give you more flexibility. So I know that's a lot to digest, but hopefully that gives you a starting point in creating your own really cool smart home. Hey Google, turn off the lights.
Okay, turning two lights off.